Hello everyone, welcome to the RightVIEWS podcast. I am Prasanna Naidu.
And I am Rahul Devdar.
And today we are going to talk about the ban which is going to be imposed by the Indian government on Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp. Basically all social media is going to just fly away according to some news sources. But why are people talking about such thing? Like, let's get into the reality. Like, how possible is it of these giant social media companies getting banned in India?
Actually, you know, it's a fairly remote possibility to summarize it basically. But if you look at it from what they have been doing is that we expect them to have a systematic plan to sort of develop their rules and procedures and have that process up for discussion. Now, what has happened is that they have been arbitrarily removing content and they have been arbitrarily flagging content on the social media networks and social media platforms, which are relevant to only one side. And it is particularly, you know, portraying the other side in a bad manner. Now, whichever side you want to pick up, the point is that you are not allowing one side to get into the discussion. So the thing is, and this is not just relevant for India. I mean, India is a sovereign country and this is applicable and we are interpreting it in the context of India. But this is also applicable in US. So we'll come to that. But to start off, what happened here in the present context is, and why our opposition members are anxious, is because there was this certain toolkit or a proposed or alleged toolkit which was leaked on social media, and the BJP spokesperson sort of tweeted it and saying, look at this, what I found on social media, and this is supposed to be the Congress toolkit. And if you read the toolkit, it seems to be from an official Congress
On the letterhead
office, and the letterhead, which is, you can say the letterhead
that,
is not,
yeah, that can be prepared by now.
Yeah, that is, it's, I mean, anyone who knows Microsoft Word or Google documents, you can prepare. How much time does it take to take out photos from the internet and make that? Anyway, that is not the point. So this toolkit was there, and someone, this BJP spokesperson shared it, and Twitter flagged it as manipulated media. Now, I'll tell you one thing. Suppose there has been a debate about Sushant Singh Rajput, and so if someone says movement where one person says something and another person says something and people are expressing opinions. But if, let's say, tomorrow Bombay High Court comes out, or one judge or one minister comes out and says that he was murdered, then police will want to investigate. How do you know that he was murdered, or whatever, he committed suicide? How do you know? That's exactly what Delhi police is doing. If Twitter is having some information that certain document is manipulated media, how did they arrive at this conclusion? They should have some proof, right? Suppose, a photo is being circulated on the internet which shows that Donald Trump is beating up some other politician, let's say Joe Biden's member party, Democrat, he's seen beating up that politician. You say, did it happen? See, we don't know, right? Unless we know that actually it happened or it didn't happen, how will we know? So if someone says that I know this is true or this is false, police will want to know, how do you know? What is the proof that you have got? Okay, I have seen, I was there when he beat up this person. Then he can say, okay, yes, this must be right because he's a witness. So then he becomes a person of interest as per law. So in that sense, Twitter became a person of interest for an investigation. Now it becomes, once the person of interest means basically you investigate and find out whether it is one of the perpetrators, it is a witness, it is a bystander, what, in what capacity, or is it a whistleblower who got this document key, you know, like you were filming this happening, you know, like Prasanna Naidu was at the office filming all this, and Prasanna Naidu's phone was in, now is now in possession of Twitter, and Twitter knows that in this phone it is, there is a proof that this document has been doctored by Prasanna Naidu and not actually by Congress party. So what is the proof? So you have in your possession certain knowledge about this information, and Delhi police wants to know what is that knowledge that you have that allows you to classify it as a manipulated medium. If it is not so, then you, why are you classifying it? You are intermediary, you say, right? And that's when that rules and regulations for information technology act, they come into play. So where they are saying that you have to be responsible on both sides. You cannot say that, you know, this particular thing is a true or false based on just random impression that you have. I don't think this is true. Immediately you flag it as manipulated media. No, you can't do that. You have to have a process. So that's why they ask them, ki, what is the process? The whatever India head or India representative of Twitter, he says, ki, I don't know anything. You know, you ask US. Ki, this is not the method. If you want to operate, so this, you follow the rules.
This is on record. Did he say this?
Yeah, he's on record. He's saying ki, everything about India is handled by the US. So basically what he's he did not admit it in so many words, but what he's saying is that he's got nothing to do with it. He's only just a, you know, pawn. So that he was roaming around all the campuses of all these colleges when he's going on a recruitment, we at Twitter are so and so and so. He's all false, because he himself has admitted in before the police, I am nobody in Twitter. I don't know what is happening in Twitter. Everything is controlled by US. I am just a pawn. So why are you going about in the colleges when they go? Like, you don't go, you know, you are not, you should actually, in fact, they don't come to the college campus when they are recruiting. Like, he is the head of Twitter India, such and so important person. Like, you are not important. You don't know anything what is happening in Twitter. Do you know the algorithm? No. Do you know how is manipulated media comes, the tag comes into play? No. Have you fact checked it? No. Then who are you? Basically, you are a pawn. Okay.
Okay, but this manipulated media tag, I don't know if it's used many times before. And if yes, then only this case it got spotted. Like a lot of media houses talking about this. Previously, it was not. Why was that so then? At least in India, maybe in US it was used.
No, see, the thing is, many of the times when you tweet and I read and it is flagged as manipulated media, I don't know. Okay. I mean, we are not important people in the context of Twitter to create that kind of an influence. Okay. And we don't generally share. So it's a percentage game. So the manipulated media, even if let's say you shared a picture which is a meme, okay, there is a famous meme of Yogendra Yadav as a mermaid, okay, that is manipulated media, it's a meme, okay, you can't write manipulated media because it is clearly a person is not a mermaid, okay, and someone has superimposed Yogendra Yadav's photo face on that mermaid, so clearly it is not. It is manipulated. We can make out. I mean, it's that doesn't need proof. Okay. But that is not flagged as manipulated media. Means there is some mechanism in which you use to, it's not an algorithm based. Okay. Now, nowadays we have such genuine deep fakes. Okay. I don't know if you have seen the video of Obama, you know, which they have made deep fake of Obama.
Yeah,
it is absolutely, you know, it is, you can't tell from the, you know, like an as a human, you can't tell whether this is a fake or a genuine video. And you can, these kinds of things can definitely be used to cause a riot. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you tomorrow such a deep fake video comes out saying ki, you know, Modi or Mamata Banerjee or some of these or Amit Shah saying something which they are not, they have never said, it is a big, big problem. So manipulated media is not a bad concept. The thing is ki, how you implement that concept is what we want to know. So if you are randomly tagging, so because this toolkit was Congress toolkit, I mean, you know, it was Congress toolkit means apparently it is Congress toolkit. So people will call it Congress toolkit. China virus was China virus. So it is called China virus. That's why it is, you know, so then you are imposing your view on us. Okay. And that is what the problem is. How are you using? Are you having some guidelines? Yes, if 2-3 fact-checking bodies, independent, like let's say Press Trust of India or Editors Guild have classified it as, you know, whatever, then you arrive. So the fact-checking that is being used is not transparent. Okay. So whatever is the mechanism for fact checking should be up on the net saying ki, this is the fact checking that we have done, this is what we have found, and that is why we are tagging this in such and such terms. Straightforward. Transparency will always be improved, no? So you are not transparent. So that is the reason for this information technology rules of 2021, which says ki, you have transparency. You bring a person who is the nodal person, because they are like, for example, Kangana Ranaut has been banned. Okay. Now, whatever she said and it was banned, whatever is the reason, you should give the reason. She made such and such tweets, which are the reason that we are banning her, and this is the process which was followed. And when similar cases, similar instances from different locations are pointed out. So let's say you give a 5-point reason argument ki why Kangana Ranaut should be banned. I will give you similar cases with the same 5 arguments are fulfilled, but the candidate is not from the right wing or supposed right wing, but it is from Congress party or some left wing candidate. Will you ban? Then it has to be uniformity of application. That is what people want. People don't want. So when Twitter and Facebook and all, what they do is they're trying to claim that they are intermediaries, that they don't have any control over the content that is published. Okay. Mm-hmm. That they don't have any control for which, which becomes viral and which results in a damage or which results in positives also, right? It might result in something positive. So we don't have control over what content gets viral and whether it causes, like suppose tomorrow there is a Twitter, whatever tweet or hashtag, which suddenly becomes viral and people start planting more trees. Okay, Twitter says ki, we don't control that. So we don't have any control over these positives. These are the advantages of social media. Suppose another hashtag becomes prominent, it becomes viral, and people start riots. So they say, we can't control the riots also because we don't know what will trigger. Okay, so this is the logic for being an intermediary, that I can't control the benefits, I can't control the fallouts, the negative fallouts. So positive fallouts also I cannot control, negative. So I can't claim benefit for this or claim responsibility for the loss. Fair enough. But then don't interfere.
Exactly.
Okay. So when you are promoting something, when you are promoting a particular hashtag on your own, then aren't you contributing to it because your algorithm is picking, you know, reinforcing it. Now the American story is very specific again with similar thing. When Trump came out and said that this is a China virus. Okay. So they asked him, ki, how is it China virus? Chinese people are not virus. saying ki Chinese people, this virus came from China. So this is called Chinese virus.
Yeah.
Okay.
He was termed racist also.
So he was termed racist and they banned all the mention of China virus from all the things, all tweets. If you had a video which said China virus, it would not get promoted, which is why RightVIEWS, our tags always include Wuhan virus. So we, our videos don't get visibility. Now, 1 year later, Biden says that we are exploring whether it is indeed leaked from this lab. And they are not just saying that it is leaked from the lab. They are saying they might deliberately be leaked from the lab. That is what they are investigating, whether it is deliberately being leaked from the lab. So now, not only has Biden's statement of investigation acknowledged that this virus has come from the lab, but it is now on the second stage, whether it was accidental leak or deliberate leak. So Trump's, you have suppressed, okay, and now he's acknowledging. So now Facebook and Twitter and all these YouTube are releasing these caps on Chinese virus, okay. And now we'll see much more of our videos being available on the recommended streams, what to watch next or something. So you will see our videos there because they do mention it is Chinese virus. So now on what basis did you ban it? And now on what basis did you accept it? Just because government said. So if you can change your view just because, I mean, in earlier government, that is president, said that it is Chinese virus, right? But they did not hear, they did not accept the government. Now Biden is saying it is Chinese virus, therefore they are accepting. So they will choose what to accept is what they are doing. So that is not acceptable as an intermediary. Then you become a publisher. Then you choose what to publish. And if you become a publisher, you become liable for all the stories that you run.
Right.
So in the toolkit also, you know, whether the toolkit is fake or genuine is completely different question. Okay. It doesn't matter whether the toolkit is genuine or fake, or whether it was actually made by Congress party or not. The what is relevant is that whatever was mentioned in the toolkit, okay, was actually being done by Congress people. So there were a few things like, you know, calling it a Modi variant or India variant, calling it, all these things were actually done in by the Congress party. They have secluded some ventilators to themselves, which that fellow in Delhi got caught. So it's like this, if you have like a, if I tell you and I give you this book saying ki, this is how Manchester United is going to play, okay, and this is their playbook. They will use three forwards and they will be attacking from the left flank. This is how they will be doing. He is the critical player who is a midfielder and he will be feeding it not to the left flank but the right flank. And actually it is happening in the match, you will tend to give more weightage to my playbook, right?
Yeah.
You don't care whether that playbook has actually been drafted by Manchester United or no. It doesn't matter. But I'm telling you, this is the playbook of Manchester United and it is actually working out.
Right.
This is exactly what is wrong with the playbook. And that is what is triggering the Congress and the opposition even more. So they have launched this campaign against the toolkit, to suppress the toolkit. And in that, Twitter got caught. So they are now trying to attack the government saying ki, you are imposing on Twitter and freedom of speech and all that. And that is the cover that they are using to attack these rules and regulations. But it is very important. If suppose tomorrow Twitter bans your tweet, okay, or removes your account or reduces your followers, then you need to know why. Okay, you can't arbitrarily do that. That's all we are saying. And there has to be a grievance redressal, and there has to be some, you know, Trump deleted some of these people from his followers, right? He blocked them. So they got a court order saying, unblock these people.
Yeah, you told me.
So these kinds of things should be allowed. When our courts will decide, they say, we don't know. That's not allowed. So how will our courts enforce these kinds of things? If tomorrow Modi bans or blocks all these people, including Rajdeep Sardesai and Barkha Dutt, then they will have to go to court saying, unblock us. But courts will not be able to enforce that, because Twitter management will say everything is in California. So it won't be possible, because nobody can, you know, investigate or interact with the US government to force Twitter in California. US government themselves can't impose on California. So there has to be a direct liaison between California. Then California will, court will order that. Or you can have a officer here and court will direct him. Indian courts will direct him to, for Indian issues. So that is the idea behind these guidelines. And I'm telling you, these social media companies are going to set the narrative for the election.
Going to. They're already doing it.
Yeah. So, but that means that they have to do it much more fairly. Okay. They can't be doing it haphazardly. We cannot have that mismanagement and causing riots in the country.
Have you watched this documentary called Social Dilemma?
No.
It's on Netflix. What is it about? Yeah, it's about this, like how social media is used for creating a lot of purpose. Also, this, I think the great hack, it was based on that election, this thing which happened with you during the Trump's election. Which company was involved? That famous company, even Congress had consulted with that company.
Yes. I remember. Cambridge Analytica.
Cambridge Analytica. So the Great Hack, it's another documentary based on that Cambridge Analytica thing.
Yeah, Cambridge Analytica. In fact, you know, if you have read the book called Sucked by Roger McNamee. Roger McNamee was an initial investor in Facebook. And he's a friend or sort of, not friend, but he was the initial investor in Facebook. So he's also founded many companies. So he's also a musician. But the book is about how their values changed. And then there is this scientist who came to him, who told them that they have sort of developed this attention algorithm, which tells them what kind of content to push.
This is exactly that in Social Dilemma. So it starts with the employees of these companies only who left the job later because morally they were feeling that it's not correct what the company.
Yeah, I think I've seen that. I think because
it was famous. It's on Netflix.
Cambridge Analytica time. I think it came out.
No. Social Dilemma came a few years ago. Cambridge Analytica ka document is the Great Hack.
2014.
I think that was the Great Hack.
No, I think it must be 2016 or 17 when I saw one document.
Yeah, then it would be Social Dilemma.
Acha. Because this book also had come out then, Zucked. Very nice book. It's tells you about what is going on, you know, some sort of...
how our data is used by these companies.
No, how their value systems have... they have ignored their values or basic values. And their value system is totally geared towards making money rather than anything else.
Yes.
And that is why all these algorithms tend to mess up all the, you know, social... fabric of the society. because they don't promote discussion. They promote fights. And people become so sure of their position that, they're completely unable to change.
Also, I mean, there's an entrepreneur named Chamath. He was a Facebook employee, and now, so he left all the, so I mean, I don't know, but he said that he removed all these apps, especially Facebook, and he started
advocating for this. No, but his behavior also is not very, transparent. I think some of the companies that he invested in were also quite almost frauds only.
Okay, I don't know about that. Okay, so if you all want to check out the rules which are being announced by the government and which these companies are supposed to follow, you can check out the link below. There's a beautiful website named PRS India. They are doing really good work. So you can check out all of the acts or rules published by the Indian government there. Also, what you feel about this incident, do tweet us about it, to send us your opinion. We would love to hear that. And do check out the other episodes available here. Thank you. Thank you so much for this.
Thank you.